Building upon our previous exploration of lift in part 1, where we delved into the theories behind lift generation, including Bernoulli's principle and Newton's third law, we are now ready to dive deeper into the practical applications and elements that shape the world of aircraft wing design and performance. In this video, we'll explore the different types of aerofoils and how they contribute to lift production. We'll delve into the various wing designs used in aircraft, discussing their advantages and disadvantages in terms of lift generation and maneuverability. Next, we'll dive into the lift formula, demystifying the equation behind this crucial aerodynamic force. So whether you're an aviation enthusiast, a student studying aerodynamics, or simply curious about how airplanes defy gravity, this video is for you. Now let's get started. In the world of aviation, the diversity of aircraft demands a range of aerofoil designs tailored to specific needs. Each type of aerofoil serves a distinct purpose, addressing factors like speed, maneuverability, stability, and efficiency. From aerobatic stunts to transonic flight, different aircraft rely on a variety of aerofoil shapes to achieve optimal performance in their respective roles. Now that we understand why there are different types of aerofoils, let's take a closer look at a few important or major types commonly used in aviation. While there are numerous variations in aerofoil designs, we'll focus on key examples that illustrate the diverse applications and characteristics of these essential components in aircraft wings. First off, we have the symmetrical aerofoil. With its perfectly symmetrical shape, featuring identical upper and lower surfaces, it's the go-to choice for aerobatic and high-speed aircraft, providing consistent lift at various angles of attack. Moving on, we have the asymmetrical aerofoil. This type of aerofoil has an asymmetrical profile, generating more lift on the upper surface. It's the standard design for most aircraft wings, striking a good balance between lift and drag. You'll find it on a wide range of aircraft, from small general aviation planes to large commercial jets. Next, there's the Clark Y aerofoil, renowned for its flat-bottomed cambered shape. This design offers stability and predictability, making it a popular choice for general aviation and light aircraft, where forgiving characteristics are essential, especially during takeoff and landing. Then there's the NACA aerofoil series, developed by the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics. These aerofoils come with specific numerical designations and offer a range of lift and drag characteristics tailored for various flight conditions across different aircraft types. From low-speed trainers to high-speed fighter jets, there's a NACA series for every application. Lastly, we have the supercritical aerofoil, engineered with a unique shape to delay shock waves and reduce drag at transonic speeds. It's commonly employed in high-speed commercial aircraft, enabling more efficient flight near the speed of sound. Now that we have explored various aerofoil shapes, which are cross-sections of the wing, let's shift our focus to different types of wing designs as a whole. Aircraft wings are crafted in diverse designs, each serving specific functions and performance needs. So let's delve into some major wing designs and the aircraft types they are commonly associated with. The elliptical wing features a shape that closely follows an elliptical planform. Historically used in iconic aircraft like the Supermarine Spitfire, this design offers excellent lift distribution and minimizes drag, making it ideal for achieving high performance and maneuverability. With its backward swept wingtips, the swept wing design is common in jet aircraft, where high speeds are paramount. By reducing drag at high velocities, this design enhances the aircraft's high-speed performance and delays the onset of compressibility effects, crucial for achieving efficiency in supersonic flight. Triangular in shape, the delta wing design is synonymous with supersonic and high-speed aircraft like the Concorde. Offering high lift and maneuverability, the delta wing configuration enables aircraft to operate effectively at extreme speeds, making it well-suited for applications where rapid travel is essential. The tapered wing, narrowing towards the tip, is a staple in many modern aircraft. This design balances lift distribution across the wing, reducing drag and improving overall efficiency. Tapered wings are commonly found in a wide range of aircraft due to their versatility and performance benefits. Allowing the wing sweep to be adjusted in flight, the variable sweep wing design offers unparalleled versatility. Found in swing wing aircraft like the F-14 Tomcat, this design adapts to different flight regimes, providing optimal performance at both low and high speeds, making it highly desirable for multi-role combat aircraft. So far, we have covered wing designs like elliptical, swept, delta, and tapered, which all describe the physical shape of the wing. Now let's shift our focus to how these wings are connected to the aircraft's fuselage. This attachment plays a crucial role in an aircraft's stability and maneuverability. Stability ensures the aircraft maintains a steady course, while maneuverability allows it to make controlled movements in the air. There are two primary ways the wings can be attached to the fuselage: the dihedral and the anhedral design. These attachment configurations significantly influence the aircraft's behavior in flight. Dihedral wings feature an upward angle from the aircraft's centerline or the horizontal of the wings, providing increased lateral stability. This design is commonly seen in general aviation aircraft, ensuring stability during flight and enhancing safety, especially during roll movements. In contrast, anhedral wings have a downward angle from the aircraft centerline or the horizontal of the wings, offering increased maneuverability and responsiveness. While less common, they are favored in certain fighter jets and high-performance aerobatic aircraft for their agility. However, they tend to sacrifice some lateral stability for enhanced maneuvering capabilities. Stability in aviation is crucial for safe and efficient flight. The choice of wing design plays a significant role in achieving desired stability characteristics. Alright, let's dive into the mechanics of lift and explore the factors that influence its magnitude. When it comes to generating lift, several key elements come into play: wing shape, angle of attack, air density, free stream velocity, and surface area. First off, let's talk about the wing shape and angle of attack. The angle of attack is the angle between the chord line of the wing and the oncoming air. Adjusting this angle allows pilots to control the lift produced. Additionally, the shape of the wing plays a crucial role in determining lift. Next up, we have airspeed. The faster an aircraft moves through the air, the greater the lift generated. That's why takeoff and landing speeds differ from cruising speeds. Lastly, wing area is a significant factor. A larger wing area provides more surface for air to interact with, resulting in increased lift. Now let's talk about the lift formula, a fundamental tool that helps us understand the components of lift production. By inputting values for factors such as wing shape, airspeed, and wing area, we can accurately predict the amount of lift an airplane will generate. The formula is L equals half times CL times rho times V square times S. Here's what each component represents. L is the lift force. CL is the coefficient of lift, which depends on the wing's shape and angle of attack. Rho is the air density, V is the airspeed, and S is the wing surface area. So in simple terms, lift is what keeps our planes in the sky. The coefficient of lift depends on the wing's shape and angle of attack. Airspeed determines how fast the air rushes over the wings. Air density indicates how thick the air is, and wing area represents how much space our wings take up. We have delved into several crucial aspects of aviation: various aerofoils, wing designs, the lift formula. Grasping these concepts is vital for any aviator. If you found this journey through the skies intriguing, hit that like button. Feel free to share your thoughts or propose topics in the comments below, and don't forget to share this video with your friends. Until next time, fly high and stay curious.